Hi, I'm Mathew Neilson from Ford Performance Racing. I'm the engineering manager here. Welcome to the Norton 360 Engineered for Speed technical section. Today we're going to have a look at the design department here at FPR. So welcome to the engineering department. As you can see, we have an open space here for the engineering group. There's six engineers plus myself sort of full-time in this facility. On the left here we have our sort of race engineering side of things, so our two of our race engineers here, Dave and Grant, working away. On the other side of the wall we have the design department. So you can see here there's three of the guys here, so our data design engineers predominantly spend their time here, obviously do their race preparation and post-event analysis, but the other component of their job is to work on the design side of things. So we've just recently signed an agreement with Phoenix PLM, so we've upgraded our CAD software to the latest UGNX, and in conjunction with that we've been able to involve the Team Center side of things, which is a piece of software that globally manages the design and the production side of things. So the guys work in conjunction with the CAD software to put the new parts into the system, where production are able to manage it from that point on. So we've got Jason Gray here, one of our data design engineers. So Jace, if you wouldn't mind just giving us a bit of a rundown on the Team Center and the NX side of things.
Yeah, well, the Team Center is a database that helps us manage all our part files, because as you can imagine, we have thousands and thousands of parts, all that have been modelled in this online environment which we call CAD. And then so the Team Center, sort of, we can control the part revisions and look at old revisions, new revisions, and then make drawings and laser cutting files, and so the guys down in production can make them.
Thanks, Jace. So you can see there, Jace has a gearbox on the system there, so just working away there. A lot of the external parts we can bring the CAD model in, so a gearbox which has been from Hollinger, we get given the CAD model to bring into our car assembly and design any parts around what we require. So just moving through, again we try and set it up so that the space is good for the guys to work in. Often they'll have parts that are physically off the car here on their benches, either doing some measurements if it's a revision, or prototype components that they're just seeing how they've gone. So a bit of a meeting table there where we can actually get together and discuss any design work that needs to go on. We have a design manager, so he's predominantly responsible for the release of the drawing. So each of the guys will release them to him. He'll check them off, make sure that they're detailed correctly, that it achieves what we're actually wanting to do. And then he'll release that to the system for production to take that on board. So he's a workshop-based position, so the work never stops from a design point of view. Interesting, over here we have our wall of pro design history for Ford Performance Racing. So all those folders here is basically all the design work since Pro 2005. So we try and maintain the paper copy side of things, because when it goes down to production, the guys will often reference that to be able to make sure that the part they're making, they've got a clear picture on what's required, particularly for tolerances, any special features that need to be added. The linking between the CAD and the other departments is probably most critical for our machine shop side of things. Basically, the parts get designed here, and then the machine shop can grab those drawings as a CAD file, adapt it to their system downstairs, so they can basically integrate the CAD design from here straight down to the machine shop and make the part. So that's the link. Up here we draw the parts, design them, and then in future episodes you'll see the actual areas where we make the parts.